Hello and welcome, and today I've got an unboxing to do, and today we're going to be looking at the Google Home Hub. So I've had a Google Home and various Google Home Minis for over a year now. I use it all the time. It is so useful. It's great for playing music, for controlling the smart devices around the home. The kids love it as well. I have a Google Home device speaker in the living room. I've got a Google Home Mini in my bedroom. I've got a Google Home Mini in my daughter's room as well. And I think, as Arthur C. Clarke once stated, any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. And that's how I feel about the old Google Home assistants, the Google Home Minis, etc., etc., because they just seem to work so well and integrate with each other. And whether you have one or lots of them, it's really quite cool. And I felt like I needed another one. As I said, I have a number of units, and the units are clever enough that they work out which is the closest one I'm to. So I could be like between two rooms and holler, "Hey Google, play some David Bowie." And the one that I'm closest to...
"All right, here's David Bowie on the main music."
For example. This may occur a number of times through this video, and I apologise. You can also connect them all up as well, so that you have one sort of massive house speaker, and it just syncs so beautifully together. You can put them into groups. So I have like an upstairs speaker group, a downstairs speaker group, and a whole house speaker group. And that includes all the my Google Homes, my Google Home Mini, and my sound system, which has a Chromecast. And it just all syncs together. There's no lag. No one system speaker or anything is out of sync with the others. But it's not just about music. That's just one of the things I really like. I use it all the time about how long my journey going to take to work, when's the next train, what's the weather like, just general questions about anything. The kids are always asking questions, and you can just ask Google. It talks in different languages if you want it to. You can set it, so I have a friend of mine speaks Japanese. It understands them. It's just, I love it. I love the Google Home and assistant. So I'm looking forward to unboxing the Google Home Hub, which is effectively a Google Assistant speaker, but with a visual aid. So it says at a glance, command your day, simplify your smart home, answers for any moment, play your favorite songs, relive your memories, make hand-free calls. So all those things that you can do with your normal Google Home Minis, but with a visual reference. But without further ado, let's unbox it. Okay, let's start with the unboxing. As you can see, there's a sort of the screen and stuff. There we go. And it looks like an old sort of small tablet on it. It's not to be confused with the tablet. You can't sort of use it with Android apps and stuff like that. But it's got the same sort of look as your standard tablet. But if we turn this over, there you'll see this is the speaker unit here. And there's the microphone on-off section there, so you can have that off. I'm just going to take the plastic screen protector off. Let's see what else is on the box, obviously. Let's get started. Manual. In my experience, these are just let's get started cards. That's it, mate. It's just plug it in, get the app, just say, "Hey Google." That's basically it. In my experience, if you've had Google Home Assistants or the Google Mini before, or whatever, then you'll know that integration is really very straightforward. And the plug here, on the other ones there's sort of a little USB, so it's not a USB connection, which is a bit annoying because you have to use this plug effectively, whereas the other ones you can always swap out with a USB charger, which I always find quite useful on the other ones. So let's just plug it in and get going. Okay, so I've cleared some space on the desk, so let's just plug this in. Plugs in the back there. There we go. And instantly the screen comes on. I've not pressed anything. As I say, these integration is usually very straightforward. Let's call up my app on my phone, because I've already got the Google Home app on.
Welcome to Google Home.
We are.
To get started, download the Google Home app on a phone or tablet.
Done that. Okay, so what you need to do is basically go to your Google, once you've downloaded the Google Home app, is add a device. Add. Set up device. New home. Your controller in this home. Home. Next. He says next. Looking for devices. Choose the device you'd like to set up. Well, the Google Home there. Next. W, so that's the code we need to check when it connects. Connected. W5, P7, it just says W5. So I'm going to go yes at the moment. Okay. Room. So this is going to be, I'm going to create a new room. I'm going to have this in the kitchen. So let's put in the kitchen is where it's going to be. Okay. Choose which Wi-Fi. Okay. My home Wi-Fi. Now it's going to take the Wi-Fi information from the phone, that because the phone's all connected to the Wi-Fi, and just integrate it. Now it's updating the software. As I say, I love being able to, the amount of versatility that it has. Here are Google Partners, yeah, privacy, yeah, next. Guests as well, you can have guests, you can have them, you can switch that on or off, but obviously Google Home recognises your voice because you can train it up, and other people's voices. So when I say play one of my Google playlists, it knows it's me rather than my kids, or my kids asking, it knows it's the kids. So here we are, teach. I agree. Okay, it already recognised I've already set up, but if you're setting up for the first time, you just basically train it, which is basically saying Google, I'm going to say it because I don't want to kick the machine off, a number of times, and it learns your voice. And as I say, that way it recognises basically your account, your Google account, from your voice. A guest can come in. Add music services. So here we are, we've got all the music services, it's just updating there. I tend to use, you've got Spotify, YouTube Music, which I think you get a premium membership for a while with the Google Home Hub. You get Google Play, which most of my music I go through Google Play, or you can play via Deezer and you just choose your sort of preferred option. It's next. Please use the default music device. So in this case, you can choose Spotify or the YouTube Music subscription, or in this case, as I say, Google Play. All my music is on Google Play, so that's what we use here in the house. Duo calling. I don't really do any duo calling. Okay, not now. Let's do not now. Google Photos, so you can select various photos to display on the screen when it's sort of not being fully used. Or curated images or full screen clock. Let's go for that for now. So that will be the clock face. Oh, you can choose clock faces. Flip clock, an old fashioned clock. 10:09. That's kind of cool. I think I'm going flip clock. Old school flip clock, mate. Still updating there. Add more of your services. Stream videos on your TV. Okay. I don't really use four, but you can add that. So there's an ambient sensor here, so up here, and it will adjust the brightness to blend in with the room, which is quite useful depending on how bright the room is. It'll constantly adjust it. You flip the switch on the back to mute or unmute, as the case may be. So remember, there's a switch on the back here for muting or unmute.
The mic's off.
There we are. The mic is
on. The microphone is back.
Okay. Volume controls. At the back, there's a slider. Let's have a look at the back again. Here, a rocker. It's a more of a rocker switch. Here. Installing update, as it has been for the last while. I say, and I use it all the time. You can also set routines, like a series of processes it goes through. So, for instance, if I say, okay, I'm going to say Google, good morning, it will go through a various sequence. It will switch on my bedroom light. It will tell me what my what the weather's like. It will tell me what the day ahead is. So, when I've got anything in my calendar, and then it will play Radio 1. Apparently my patient will be rewarded. Okay, so now we're going to finish up here, set up here. There's the clock.
Welcome to your Google Home Hub. It has the Google Assistant built in.
Hi, how can I help?
So you can use your voice to get help at a glance. Check it out. Jumpstart your day with a personalised routine. Just say, hey Google, good morning. For the weather, your calendar, reminders,
sure, turning on the main bedroom
light.
The commute
light.
To work is 20 minutes by car.
See, simply my phone here in this.
Where you can get useful info about your day, check out videos and recipes, and explore all the things your assistant can do. Have a question? Get answers from Google or watch helpful videos from YouTube. Hey Google, show me how to cut a pineapple.
Okay, playing on YouTube.
Now you can see and control all your devices from a single dashboard. Just swipe down from the top of the screen for home view, where you can see the status of your home, view devices in each room, and adjust the lights, pause the TV, and monitor cameras, like the Nest Hello Video doorbell. Hey Google, show me the front door.
I don't have a Google Nest doorbell yet.
Unwind in the evening with songs and videos from compatible music providers like YouTube Music. Hey Google, play Dua Lipa. Swipe up from the bottom of the screen to adjust volume or brightness. Or use the volume buttons behind the right side of the display. To turn off the mics, simply slide the mic mute switch. And relive your memories with Google Photos. See your favorite albums, even when the display is not in use. Setup is simple in the Google Home app. You can also search for photos by voice. Hey Google, show me my photos from Cornwall. What's this? It's Hub's Ambient EQ light sensor. It allows Hub to automatically match the colors and lighting in any room, so photos on Hub blend in with your home. And when it's time for bed, Hub knows to dim for a good night's sleep. Remember, if you ever want to learn more, just say, hey Google, what can you do? Ready to give Hub a try? swipe from the left edge of the screen to exit and get started.
Right, here we go. So swipe, there we are. So the, you know, displaying the information on the screen there, saying Friday. There's my view of the rooms, the various rooms. So kitchen display, living room. Oscar's bedroom. What about Freya's room? My daughter's room there. My bedroom. There's my bedroom. He said, "Put the, let's turn the light off." Thermostat, various media in there. You can broadcast. That's interesting.
What's your message?
It's dinner time.
All right, broadcasting now.
It's dinner time.
Now that, so the broadcast facility will broadcast the message on all the speakers around the house, which is great for getting the kids to come down for when it's dinner time. What else we got? We've got top stories, so you can set some of the news that you want for your information cards. Google Music, various YouTube. For your morning, you can set some routines here. So I know who's asking. So again, it recognises the voice, which is the key thing here. Hey Google, good morning. You see, it's got
sure,
my picture
turning
there.
Turning on the main bedroom light.
So now it's going through this sequence. I set up this sequence earlier, so it's turned on my main bedroom light.
Hi, Lord Kenzel.
Yep, that's
the
what
time
it calls
is 10:58 a.m. Currently in Kintbury, it's 6 degrees and cloudy. Today, it'll be cloudy, with a forecast high of 8 and a low of 5. The best way to get to work by public transport is to catch GWR departing at 11:51 a.m. from Kintbury, a 13-minute walk from your current location.
So I've set up this sequence of
it'll take
questions.
About 1 hour and 40 minutes to get there, including one change. Today at 7 p.m, you have PTA quiz.
PTA quiz
have
I'm hosting.
Have a wonderful day.
Thank you. So there you go. And then it will play Radio 1. Because that's what I've set it up to do. So you can set up this sequence. Okay, Google, stop. Hey, Google. Show me how to make carbonara.
Sure, here are some recipes.
Okay, so it's got some recipes here. And look, start
there
cooking.
There are 8 ingredients. You can ask for the next ingredient or skip to the instructions.
That's quite useful.
The first ingredient is 1 pound dry spaghetti.
Okay, Google, stop. Okay, Google, play David Bowie.
All right, here's David Bowie on Google Play Music.
That. Hey Google, show me my photos from Cornwall.
Showing your photos.
These are old photos from Cornwall, but it knows various photographs. You know, that's the thing, if you've got Google Home Photos, it knows various photographs. Hey Google, show me my photographs from Devon.
Showing your photos.
So you can adjust the volume there. Settings about device. As you see, very useful. How are these cards? Top stories. For the news stories, I think you can set where these news stories come from. And we're back to the clock. So as you can say, and the sound as well, the sound quality is not too bad. It's about probably the same standard as the Google Home Mini generally. But there you are. It's very easy to set up. I'm going to spend some more time with it. I think this is going to go in the kitchen rather than my bedside table one. But
as you can see, generally it integrates really well, but it gives you that added benefit of a visual aid. Let's try, actually, before we do that. Hey Google, show me how to make carbonara on YouTube.
Sure, showing how to make carbonara.
There we are. And so I could pick one of these YouTube results with Jamie Oliver, whatever.
Pasta, cream, bacon. Cream?
And it will show me how to make carbonara. Okay, Google, stop. Not obsessed by carbonara, but it's the first thing that came into my head. So there you go, the Google Home. I'll report back on how I found it, but I think this is going to be another great addition to the smart home in general. And I love having the Google Homes, and this is just another great device to have. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, comments, put your comments down below, like, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye.